فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Anas radiallahu anhu reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Eat suhoor, the pre-dawn meal. Surely there is blessing in suhoor."
عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم تسحروا فإن السحور بركة فإن السحور بركة.
حديث أنس بن مالك أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said تسحروا صح؟ What does تسحروا mean؟ It's فعل أمر. It's a command. If the Prophet commands something, what does it show? واجب. The Prophet commands you something, it's obligatory. So is suhoor wajib? Based on this hadith. No, based on this hadith. Based on this hadith is wajib. Yeah, I forget, what did we say for the qa'idah? Well, if you forget something? رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَخِذْنَا إِن نَسِيْنَا أَوْ أَخْطَعْنَا. So if you forget something, we're going to come, more details into that issue. Suhoor is what? By the way, you have to remember something, yeah, when it comes to the word sahur, and then we have suhoor. Sahur is actually what? The timing of the suhoor, right? Sahur bit fath al-sin. If you say suhoor, that is the action. It's the fi'l. Sah? Bit fath al-sin is what? What's eaten at the timing, sah? The timing and the thing that's eaten at the timing. Whatever you bring me, I can say, oh, this sahur is nice. Sahur. The dates and the milk and the... If you're Somali, you eat sor. Huh? Sah? It helps you a lot, by the way. Sor, I don't know. What's sor in English? I forget it all the time. It's that white stuff. It's just white. Porridge. It's not porridge. It's a bit different from porridge. Maize. Yeah? It's a wheat. It's a bit stronger than a porridge. It goes, brothers, it goes way. I don't have it. I don't like it. But ask a Somali to show you suhoor. Go to the Somali masjids. If suhoor time, they give it. Some white, they add milk to it and sugar. Yeah? Whole? Cornmeal. Maize. That's the word, that's it, maize. Brothers, wallahi, Ramadan, you ain't gonna feel anything. Because it just doesn't digest, it's just there, all day, sits in the stomach. Huh? So sahur is what's eaten. And suhur, bidhammi sin, it's a what? Al-fi'lu, the action. It's when what you're doing when you're eating. Just like tahur and tuhur, right? Tahur is the what? Is the pot and the pan and the water that's been, that's tahur. Tahur is the action of purifying yourself. Wadu and wudu. Sah? It's the same. But then this hadith, tasaharu, do suhoor, which is a command. We have another hadith that came and they diverted it from obligation and he made it recommended. This is how you deal with the evidences. Pay attention. If I mentioned the other evidence to you, this will be obligatory. Suhoor will be obligatory, and if you don't leave it, you're sinning. Tasaharu, because the Prophet commanded it. But we realize through other narrations that it's not obligatory. So this command shows what? Learned the Amr, the commands of the Prophet two types. Amrun lil wujub, command which is obligatory. Amma amrun lil istihbab, that is recommended. This is recommended with what? There's an external other evidence. What's the external other evidence that show that it's recommended and it's not obligatory? Is the fact that the Messenger wawasala, he that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam attached many fastings together. Did he not? He done what's known as wisal, right? What's wisal? And yasuma yawmayni fa'akthar, right? It's the person fast 2 days or more. Fala yuftir, and he doesn't break his fasting. Are you with me, brothers? The Prophet used to do that. Abdullah ibn Zubair. Either it's Abdullah ibn Zubair, and I think it's Abdullah ibn Zubair, or his father. Zubayr ibn Awam, radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, may Allah be pleased with them. And I think it's Abdullah ibn Zubayr. He fasted continuously for 15 days. He did wisal 15. Half of Ramadan. He did it with what? Nuqila anhu, it was transmitted from him. Minan fawaid, huh? When they say to you, calm, 15 days. Because he never lived on chicken and chips. And kebab. These people, subhanAllah, they were what? They were aqwiya, brothers. So that's important for us to know. Now we have to realize that the Prophet ﷺ has said that فَإِنَّ السُّحُورَ بَرَكَةٌ السُّحُورَ is barakah. So let's mention some of the barakahs that are in it. Number one, فَمِنْ بَرَكَةِ السُّحُورِ, from the barakahs that are in the suhoor is التَّقَوِّي عَلَى الْعِبَادَةِ. You're actually going to become strong for the ibadah. And Allah loves that. Imagine you don't do suhoor, yeah? And you say, I don't want to have suhoor. And in dhuhr, you're like, oh, I'm tired. And asr comes, you're like, oh, I'm even tired. And then iftar comes, what did you pray all day? Your mind is gone. Does that make sense? Is that what the sharia wants you to do? The sharia needs you to be strong. And suhoor brings that. What does it bring? So it is what? Al-isti'anatu ala ta'ati Allahi ta'ala. It gives you real dependence to fast properly. Praying. So your ibadat is not based on kasal and laziness. صح? Number two. The person who takes the suhoor and eats good suhoor, they actually will enjoy the fasting and will desire to fast more. And you don't burn out. You'll actually say, you know what, I actually love fasting. It's actually a nice thing. And I've realized that the days I have suhoor, that day I'm ready, toe to toe. Brothers, you ready? I'm ready. That's the days when it's what? Suhoor. The day when I don't have suhoor, I'm like, are you speaking to me, akhi? I even can't hear properly. And that's what happens. But the days you fast with the suhoor, brothers, you have in your heart, is diyadu min as-siyami. You have actually passion and love for it. You wish you can fast more like this. And the sharia, and because that the issue of tadayukh, when you find something hard, the love also decreases. And the ibadah requires what? Kamalu dhulli ma'a kamali al-mahabba. Complete love with complete humiliation. So the love reduces. You start disliking it. So you don't want, suhoor helps you, brothers. Are you with me? Wallahi, a sheikh of mine, may Allah grant him Jannah. The first 15 days of Ramadan, he gave us benefits pertaining to suhoor only every day for 1 hour. And the ahkam only on suhoor. And things pertaining to suhoor. Sahih, brothers. I have notes on it, wallahi. Notes. This religion is wasi', man. It comes from many angles. Are you with me, brothers? So, just these two points, some of you guys are like, wow, I didn't realize that. And I actually even look at it like that. Number three. The third barakah that he has is ittiba'u sunnah. You actually follow the Prophet. You are actually following the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. That's a high station. Sah? You're following him, alayhi salatu wasalam. Because he, sallallahu alayhi wasalam, what did he mention? Tasaharu fa inna fi suhuri barakah. You're actually saying, Rasulullah said it. Oh, I'm going to follow him. And following the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasalam, is evidence that you love Allah. So it just goes back to the issue of love again. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحِبِبُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ صح؟ So if you love Allah, تبارك وتعالى, there's a way to measure if a person loves Allah. صح؟ What's the way to measure it? The Salaf, they said, this is the ayah of imtihan, the ayah of testing. Testing of what? Your love. Yeah, you love Allah. You said you love Allah. Yeah, let's see, you follow the Prophet. You love Allah, you look like, hey? You look like a rapper. Yeah? You look like a rapper and you say, I love Allah, Allah, I love Allah. And you don't look nothing like a Muslim. If people saw you on the road, they'll say, oh, he just gave me salams. They wouldn't know any sign of Islam on you. Are you with me, brothers? That this, we're not going to say the love of Allah is not present in you, no doubt there is. It can be, but it's weak. The poet said, تَعْصِ الْإِلَهَ وَأَنْتَ تَزْعُمُ حُبَّهُ. You disobey Allah and you claim His love. هذا لعمرك في القياس شنيع. That's something that the mind can't accept. Allah, can the mind accept that? I love you, I love you, I love you, but I won't listen to you. I love you, I love you, but I won't follow you. لو كان حبك صادقا لأطعته. Your love, if it was true, you would have obeyed him. For verily, the one who loves obeys the one he loves. Number four. With the suhoor, what does it give you, brothers? What did we mention? Ramadan is a time when the ibadah is 30 nights, صح? Are you with me, brothers? If you come with suhoor, what do you do before you eat? You make dua, right? That you wouldn't have got if you were sleeping. The dua that you say, Bismillah. That itself is. This Bismillah is not a normal Bismillah in the days of the year. This is Ramadan. You've just said Bismillah in Ramadan. Did we just say that this timing, this virtue of this time is amazing, right? The actions are being multiplied here. It's not a joke. Not only that, the dua that you make, the gratitude and that which you're showing and the ibadat which you're coming with. And not only that, if a person has suhoor, what's the chances of him praying Salatul Jama'ah? Fajr, high. It's actually high, the fact that you're going to go to the masjid, you're actually going to be there. Not only that, you're actually going to pray the sunnah before Fajr. All of that. Are you with me? Brothers, all of that comes through suhoor. So Sharia is waking you up in advance for the prayer, but you're eating for it. You're eating for it. Number five is, من بركة السحور is what? أن فيه مخالفة لأهل الكتاب. You're opposing the أهل الكتاب, the people of the scripture. And this is something the Sharia really works towards, that the Muslims are distinct and they're not like them. Are you with me? That's why the Prophet ﷺ, he said, فصل ما بين صيامنا, the difference between our fasting وصيام أهل الكتاب and the fasting of the people of the scripture is what? What's the difference? أكلت السحور, the eating of the suhoor. We want to oppose them in everything, brothers. Yeah, everything. Everything. We eat suhoor just so we can oppose them. They don't eat it, we eat it. That's how the Sharia works. ولذلك, there's a book I advise you to all look into. It's called اقتضاء صراط المستقيم لمخالفة أصحاب الجحيم. Are you with me, brothers? Written by Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. Also, Shaykh Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah, there's a risala which is mafqood. We haven't seen it yet, been published yet. It's been mentioned, so scholars mention it and they reference it. Is Hukmu Yawm al-Sabt, written by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. Are you with me? He talks about this issue of At-Tashabbuh bil-Kuffar. He mentions it in there. Also, Al-Imam al-Dahabi, rahimahullah. Al-Imam al-Dahabi, there was a fasting, there was a celebration on Thursdays which Muslims started to imitate the disbelievers with. And Al-Imam al-Dhahabi rahimahullah, he authored a book in this issue of At-Tashabbuh bil-Kuffar. So what it is here is that this fifth barakah that has is that you are distinct now. You're taking a path other than their path. Are you with me? And now one of the things that Muslims are being caused and problems that Muslims are being faced is this issue of integration. Are you with me, brothers? فيه خير وفيه شر. There's good and evil in it. If the integration means that we don't harm them, we don't cause them any problems, we don't afflict them with any pain, that we're here with a covenant, we're here with a contract, we're in their land, هذا شيء. That's one thing. That's something مسلم شرعا. We're not here to attack you guys. We're not here to take over your country. We have nothing to do. We don't want to turn the House of Commons. We don't want to turn it into the Kaaba or something. We're not there to do that. No. Unless it turns itself to the Kaaba. The second thing, but the thing is what? But if they mean integration in the sense where we dress the same, we look the same, we talk the same, we act the same, we are the same. Nah, the mic. Sharia doesn't accept that. Sah? But if I carry on saying this, I might be on dispatches. Those guys are good, they're good. Little snippets, yeah. Quick. Ayah, number six is Number six is what we already mentioned, Salatul Fajr, Fa'al Jama'ah, Fi Waqtiha Al-Fadil. The person comes to Salatul Jama'ah, Fajr, they pray with the people. Now, brothers, if you're doing suhoor, what is it that you should eat?
Allahu Akbar. MashaAllah, barakallahu fi. She's grown. Allahu Akbar.
The suhoor, when the person eats, they should eat the minimum. Don't go too overboard. Eat what fills you, good, but your mind can still focus. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith Abu Huraira, ni'ma suhoor al-mu'min al-tamru. The barakah and the good of the person's suhoor is what? Date. Some people have suhoor, they don't have dates. Have dates, let it be there. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made what? Ni'ma, blessed. Dates are very good. Very good, brothers. So don't go over, don't exaggerate and go over and fill yourself and say, oh, today's a long day, I have to work. Just eat, go, stomach, just talk still. And later when you want to scratch your stomach, you scratch it from there. Because it's gone so big. That is, so basically don't forget the thuluth. Are you with me? I remember we were eating with one sheikh one time and we were eating and I reminded the sheikh, I said, sheikh, thuluth. Then the Prophet said, because he ate, I could see he was going in, the sheikh was going in. So I said, sheikh, thuluth. And he said to me, everybody knows their thuluth. Thuluth is subjective, right? My thuluth is different from yours. I can probably eat all of this, is my thuluth. Sah? Ayyay, faddal.
Sahal ibn Sa'ad, radiallahu anhu, reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, people will continue to adhere to good as long as they hasten to break the fasting.
عن سهل بن سعد رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا يزال الناس بخير ما عجلوا الفطرة. متفق عليه.
This hadith is a dalil and it's a manners and an etiquette min adab al-iftar when it comes to breaking the fast. And that is what? Ta'jiluhu wal-mubadala. To hasten it and to do it fast and quickly. Some people, they think it's a sign of righteousness to delay and relax and say, I'm fine, I really want, I'm not bothered. I'll have it when you're... La, that's not the sunnah. The person, as soon as sun sets, he breaks his fast. And there's a lot of khair in that. From the khair that's in there, no doubt, is the following of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَالْعَمَلُ بِسُنَّتِهِ And you're doing what he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's sunnah was like. His sunnah. Also, there are many narrations that show based on the hadith of Abu Darda radiallahu anhu, which he said, ثَلَاثٌ ثُرِي مِنْ أَخْلَاقِ النُّبُوَّةِ It is from the etiquettes and the manners of the prophets. Not just Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but the previous prophets as well. تَعْجِيلُ الْإِفْطَارِ Hastening the iftar, breaking of the fasting. وَتَأْخِيرُ السُّحُورِ And delaying the suhoor. وَوَضْعُ الْيَمِينِ عَلَى الشِّمَالِ فِي الصَّلَاةِ And placing the right hand on top of the left hand in the prayer. Are you with me, brothers? But remember, placing the hand on the right, on the left, that's the Anbiya, that's the Sunnah of the Prophets. So this is not from the Sunnahs of the Prophets. To just let your hands freely. Placing your hand on, but where do you place the hand, brothers? Huh? There's a book written called, it's called Fathul Ghafur, Biwad'i al-Aidi ala al-Sudur. Fathul غفور بوضع الأيدي على الصدور. I read that book is written by Muhammad Hayat Sindhi رحمه الله. He's a teacher of Muhammad Abdul Wahab. He was his teacher, Muhammad Hayat Sindhi. When I read that, wallahi, I was focusing on this particular issue very seriously, trying to get so much, and I was trying to get to the bottom of this issue of placing the hands, and took a lot of my time. and comparing it to other books that were written, and what I came with is the conclusion is there is no authentic hadith whatsoever regarding where you need to put your hand when it comes to. There's no authentic hadith at all. The one that's, so they're all weak. But, so we're now talking about weakness so amongst all of them. Like in the one that's weakness is the what? The least. The least. So all weak. But the one who has the baby weakness is placing it on your chest. That's why I've just taken that from that angle. Because it's the weakest. It's the lowest of the weakest. Does that make sense? No, the highest of the weakest. Huh? The least weakest. Huh? Doesn't even sound nice, but yeah. But there is no authentic hadith pertaining to it from the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. Are you with me, brothers? So there is wus'. What's wus'? It's a matter which really shouldn't be made into a fuss then. Where you put it here? You put it here? I put it here? You want to put it here? All of that, as long as that right is on top of that left. That's clear from the Prophet. Are you with me? So Muhammad Hayati Zindi tries to prove in that book, he tries to prove that the hand has to be put on the chest. I was looking at his narrations. I looked at other people, tried to bring other narrations for it. I looked at the riwayat and I tried to cross-check them all, give it a fair judgment on this issue. لا يخلو من مقال. Every narration from amongst them, there could be a question put to it. The closest that they have towards the chest, and the strongest closest to it, is the riwayah of Ikrimah, which is Mursal. The riwayah of Ikrimah, which is Mursal, that's the closest. And inshallah ta'ala, bi'ibni Allah, this is a promise from me. I'm going to be explaining that book, inshallah ta'ala, Fathul Ghafur, biwad'i al-aidi ala al-sutur. Ala al-sudur, sudur, sudur. Sa'ad. So this hadith tells us, thalathu min akhlaq al-nubuwati, three are from the etiquettes and the manners of the prophets. From them is ta'jeel al-iftar, hastening the fasting. Sah, brothers? And the salafu hadhi al-umma, for example, Bukhari brings in his sahih, mathalan. Al-imam al-Bukhari brings in his sahih, after Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, hina ghaba qarsu al-shamsi. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, as soon as the sun qarsed, the sun, he broke his fast. No, delaying. Didn't really wait for everything to become dark. No, not at all. Amr ibn Maymun al-Awdi. What did he say? كان أصحاب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أسرع الناس إفطارا وأبطأهم سحورا. He said that the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم were what? The hastiest. They were the fastest in breaking their iftar. وأبطأهم سحورا. And when it came to the suhoor, they were the delay. They would delay it the most. They would take it to its last point. When he says كان أصحاب رسول الله كان, the word كان is أفعال that show what? It shows mudawama, consistency. This is how they were. Second thing that shows us, he said, "Ashabu Rasulillah." I mean, this is all the companions. Huh? Amr ibn Maymun al-Awdi mentioned. Are you with me? What about if a person breaks their fast? And when they break their fast, they thought when they were breaking their fast that the sun set. They thought the sun set. وَلَمْ تَغْرُبْ وَعَلَيْكُمْ السَّلَامُ. So we're talking about a person, man aftara yadhunnu anna shamsa qad gharubat. A person who breaks his fast thinking that the fast broke. Sunset, sorry. And it becomes clear to him what? And it becomes clear to him after that it wasn't the case. We'll say, فَصَوْمُهُ صَحِيحٌ. His fasting is sahih. لِأَنَّهُ مَعْذُورُ شَرْعًا. In the sharia, he's excused. Is he not excused? مَعْذُورُ شَرْعًا. But what's upon him is what? What's upon him is يُمْسِكُ عَنِ الْأَكْلِ حَتَّى تَغْرُبَ الشَّمْسِ. But he has to withhold from eating until the sun sets. He ate and he realized, oh no, subhanAllah. Are you with me, brothers? He has to hold back and carry on his fasting. Are you with me? He takes the ruling of a person who done it from رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَخِذْنَا إِن نَسِينَا أَوْ أَخْطَأْنَا. He done a mistake. Are you with me, brothers? He done a mistake. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, we mentioned the hadith sahih Muslim. What did Allah say? قَدْ فَعَلْتُ. وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ it says, نَعَمْ. Ikhwani, another last point that I'm going to conclude with, inshallah ta'ala, is, brothers, whilst you're fasting and you're breaking your fast right now, ينبغي للصائم, the person who's fasting is upon him, my brothers and sisters, take this advice, أن يغتنم لحظات الإفطار. Brothers, benefit from this opportunity of the time of iftar when you're breaking your fast. Why? This is awqatul ijaba. This is the time when the dua is going to be accepted. So the person should make dua فَيَدْعُ بِمَا أَحَبْ. Supplicate and ask from Allah that which you love, from the khair that you need. Because for verily you have فَإِنَّ لَهُ دَعْوَةً مُسْتَجَابًا. At this particular moment your dua is accepted, and it's the time when it's accepted. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the hadith is found by Imam al-Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, والحديث له شواهد. It has many other narrations to strengthen it. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ثلاثة لا ترد دعوتهم. Three types of people, their dua is not rejected and it's not turned back to them. Number one is al-Imam al-Adil, the just leader, who's fair to his people and he judges them correctly and by the book of Allah. والصائم, and the one who is fasting, حين يفطر, when he's breaking his fast. He's fasting when he's breaking his fast. Also, his dua is accepted. وَدَعْوَةُ الْمَظْلُومِ, and the dua of the one who's been oppressed. And that falls in the hadith that we mentioned. وَاتَّقِ دَعْوَةَ الْمَظْلُومِ فَإِنَّهُ لَيْسَ بَيْنَهَا وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ حِجَابٌ. Are you with me? Fear the oppressed one, for verily there is no veil between him. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu ta'ala anhumah, may Allah be pleased with him and his father. Inna lissa'ib inda fitrihi. The person who is fasting, he has when he's breaking his fast, la da'wah, he has a supplication. Ma turaddu, it's not rejected. The Prophet ﷺ is saying, the person who is fasting at the time of breaking his fast, he has the opportunity of a dua. If he makes it, it will not be rejected. Ibn Abi Mulaika, who said, and he's a tabi'i, min al-thiqat, wa rawa lahu a'immat al-sitta, all the six scholars of hadith narrated from him. He used to say that Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, idha aftara, whenever he would break his fast, he would say, Allahumma inni as'aluka bi rahmatika. Oh Allah, I ask you with your mercy, oh Allah. Allati wasi'at kulla shay'in, that mercy which has become vast and large over everything. أن تغفر لي, that you forgive me. Also, what is also recommended to say once breaking your fast is that which Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنه also narrated. You can find Abu Dawood and others narrated it. To say, ذهب الظمأ وابتلت العروق وثبت الأجر إن شاء الله. Some mashayikh, they question the authenticity, because Sheikh Muqbil ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i rahimahullah, and I think so, if I'm not wrong, Sheikh Muqbil weakened it. If I'm not wrong, Sheikh Nasir al-Din al-Albani rahimahullah authenticated it. And that which personally I'm inclined to is ذهب الظمأ وابتلت العروق وثبت الأجر إن شاء الله is not صحيح لعلتين اثنتين, two reasons. Abu Ishaq al-Sabi'i is a mudallis. If he narrates with an'ana, فروايته لا تؤخذ. Abu Ishaq al-Sabi'i is a mudallis, right? And his tidlis is actually one of the harshest tidlis. So his narrations are accepted. And another illa, which is illa ghamidha, we're not going to go into right now. Anything which I have said that was wrong, any mistake that came out of my mouth, is from me and shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh. Tomorrow, same time, 5 o'clock to 10 o'clock, we'll finish the book inshaAllah ta'ala.